Hey everyone, we're back once again. Gonna play another game on Deity, and this week we're going with Spain. Spain are a very strong civilization. They have double exploration bonus. So, you know, you find a tile, a named tile, you're gonna get 20 instead of 10 in the ancient era. And you start with navigation, which means you can take advantage of whales and galleons from the beginning of the game, which is huge. Gives you a huge leg up when it comes to exploring islands. And then you can also use it offensively or defensively for guarding your cities or attacking as well. In fact, in this game, I'm going to use a pretty interesting strategy, which I think you're going to like. It's dead simple, and you can just wipe out the computer pretty simply with a Spanish. Looks like we're in the south, and you could play it risky, try to run around a little bit here. Maybe we'll go this way, huh? How's it looking? Don't see any whales. Settle right here. Doesn't look like I'll be getting any whales this time. Looks like I can see the Indians through the clouds up here. Let's just play it safe. We'll plant right here, I believe. Could be risky and run around, but let's not. Just play it safe. You don't have to have an amazing start to kick some butt with the Spanish. Damn! My ass kicked. Two ancient relics, artifacts, whatever you want to call them. Make sure you get your units out before that auto turn screws you over. Looks like we have to explore as much as we can here. This is very good. We got a caravan, which means we can try to find some named tiles now. A whale over here. Wow. A lot of whales over here. Alright, nothing there, really. Well, let's keep moving. Wow. A lot of barbarians, because I just grabbed that hut. This guy's actually going to get veteran status from the single hut right here. And this guy can proceed north now. Go ahead and rush another guy here. Damn, I haven't hit a tile yet. This is a weird peninsula. Going way down here. Just to grab this 20 gold. Oh man, there are two whales over here.
Damn.
Alright, so I'm in a pretty strange spot over here all by myself. Some days I swear these maps are getting bigger on me. Spanish bonus is starting to pay off here. So I got two warrior armies pumped out. It's time to start thinking about whether it's worth pumping more. It looks like I only have two directions to explore, so. East and west, so. I may actually chill on the production. With the Spanish, you really want to just get five technologies. And actually a boat is absolutely necessary at this point, so I'm going to go ahead and build a boat, take advantage of their early bonus. Damn, this guy has to go so far. I mean, what a weird peninsula, look at that. Should be able to get a boat out right here. Gonna have to rush it though. Okay. I haven't found a single civilization yet. Kind of crazy. And I'm going to start researching alphabet. Why not? Got another friendly hut here. Hopefully no one steals that. Quite a lot of whales down here. Can't say I like my positioning very much. Because I'm gonna have to drive into this giant bay with my boat, so I'm probably gonna move my second settler to the north side over here so I have better access. Like here would be a decent spot, two trees and access up north there. Or even over here. So, yeah. Oh, Romans are stealing goodies from me. Romans are doing a decent job covering their area over there. check here real quick. You never know. Might as well just change it and see what happens here. Pottery. Never seems to work the way you want it to. So I'm gonna have to move quickly. Still a few goodies left on the map. See if my boat can spot something for me. Spot for them. Just moving the forest here. Why not? Looks like I found the Greek, perhaps. Yep. Tough defense. These guys never have money, so. Yeah, they give them money. Romans might, though. He's willing to pay 35 for navigation. That's a lot of money. See what they have. You got an archer hanging out. I'm not gonna even think about messing with the Greek. Here we go. Got to take advantage of that. So much gold. 20 gold at this point is a lot. Oh, it would suck to lose this game. This game. Battles be any slower. Speed the damn things up, for God's sake. Well, screw this. Warrior's probably just gonna run away from me the whole time, so I'm not gonna play footsie with him. So I'm up to 3 techs. What I want to do now is get bronze working and iron working. Can't believe this guy just came back. So he's gonna have... May as well eliminate him. Get veteran. Nice. So I picked up another tile, and the French are right here, so I've located them. Might as well keep running with that thing. Barbarians are just destroying me. Looking for some goodies. Nothing too exciting quite yet. He's getting crushed by these barbarians. Name tiles. Ooh. So could pick up second settler, but I'm not gonna do that quite yet. See if I can sell some technologies. Looks like I can sell Alphabet pretty easily. So I just continue exploring. See if the Greek are interested as well. Sure, peace. He's got nothing, man. I think the Romans will play with me though. Yeah, they got money. It's worth it. It's only a 20 gold tech. I mean, 20 beaker. I'm not giving them navigation, though. It's too much. So let's plot a lot of gold. That's going to help me rush all the galleons. I'm going to get a fleet of galleons going. Ooh, no. Hope they don't get me. Alright, I think an Indian's right here, so... Oh man. This is rough. It's like a donut. It's like a giant... This is a ginormous peninsula that comes up to the northwest. Yeah, so... Question is, where to put a good city here? It's a pretty good spot right there. Right up on this hill. I'd like to take advantage of these whales, but it's not as crucial in this as it may be in like a another circumstances. I'm not really concerned with growth at this point. Wow. Double whale. Pretty good. Yet another hut. Yeah, not finding anything too exciting quite yet. Two trees, two beakers, good enough for what I need to do here. I may be able to go get that. There's another barbarian hut over there. You never know, so might as well give this a try. Nope. Oh, ho. Yeah. As if the Spanish need more gold. In fact, that reminds me I should really rush the barracks once this finishes up. Build that next turn. These guys are so lazy. Look at this. They are right on top of these barbarian huts and not even getting them. Just pathetic. This is a little cost saver right here. Goodness gracious. Now we want iron working. And that'll get us to 5 technologies for the double naval combat bonus. Put this back to science. And let's rush that building. This guy's gotta heal up. This is not an overrun, by the way. Wow. I'm just cruising on gold right now. Well, I've got the gold, I may rush these boats out before they get expensive. I'm getting so much money anyway, so may as well use it. So I can access... I think I see how I'll do this. I'm going to come out of this bay right here. Probably hit the Romans first. And then go north and hit Delhi. And then sweep around the outside of this continent. I'm just going to load this boat up with like 9 to 12 legions. And you're going to see some magic. I'm going to rush another one, so I have my fleet. And try to get this guy over there as fast as I can. A lot of fun. This terrain is miserable. Let's see, what are my options here? Still 50. And perhaps sell them something? Why not, right? That's half a legion. And gonna want to be careful. Make sure this guy doesn't... Oh, man, that is so much gold. Gonna go ahead and get it, just in case. Don't want to lose that. And it's also gonna net me currency, whether I like it or not. Slow warriors get around a little bit. So much gold. So I'm heading into the medieval era. And just gonna try to keep the Romans in check. They don't try to tiptoe over to my cities and cause problems. I don't think that'll make them heal up, but do it anyway. So let's stick to covering. Alright, there's another one. I'm gonna pick up ironworking here so I can start pumping out. Pumping out dudes as fast as I can. At this point, I don't even really need anything. Maybe pick up masonry. Just so I don't have to deal with a wall. Heal him up. I don't want to deal with any issues. Still looking for Atlantis. Nothing in sight yet. Spanish is just unbelievable, picking up so much gold. Guys out of defend. Come on. Just stop it. So I picked up a spy, which is handy. Let's put her on the boat. Spy is my favorite way to crack a city open. Just kind of driving around, looking for things to get. And pumping these guys out as fast as I can. Once they're ready, I'm going to have to drive them over to Rome and boogie down. Alright, that's what I was looking for. These guys on the boat. Try to get these guys to move out a little bit. and take advantage of this hill. And we're gonna have to bring this boat back. All right. Got a lot of legions here. 7, 8. Or whatever it is, it's a lot. And hopefully I get this wall so I don't have to deal with... Great. So... To be honest, I don't really need anything else at this point. The game's pretty much over. Computer's just being super quiet. There's like nothing going on. No attacks, nothing. You gotta bring these boats back and you reunite these guys. It's over here. Not much. Check and see what the Romans think. Looks like they're still mad. No idea where Atlantis is. Some off in some corner somewhere. Dangerous. I'm gonna have to go here because this guy's trying to get it. I could lose this. Finally, a little bit of luck. Start loading them up. I might make one army here. If you have no idea what I'm doing, you'd probably think I'm insane at this moment. But I assure you, you'll see exactly what I'm doing. Alright, what do we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Is that right? About 8 legions. An army. Let's get one more. Terrain's pretty awful. I mean, it's just not very easy to access these guys. So, 1, 2, 3. 2, 3. So it's just gonna take me a lot of turns just to get over there. Just for insurance, might as well build this and choke this little area. Can make life a little more difficult. So, here we go. Let's go get the Romans. Thanks, bud. Wait for my naval support to show up. Normally you'd want to take advantage of the tree, but I think I'll be alright. They're gonna have 18 defense, so that's kind of paying my butt. Thankfully I have the spy to help out with that. That's a weird bug. Look at that. He thinks I can't use all these units. I always run into these strange bugs. I don't get it. Damn. It's not good. So they've got this military bonus. Veterans combined with that's gonna make it a little harder than it would originally be, because it would be a 9 on 15, but instead I'm dealing with a 9 on 18. The idea is you could attack 9 on 18 like, well, you could attack 9 on 15 like 12 times. I mean, you're gonna destroy him at that rate. For a very low cost. But I'm gonna have to go for it here, just to whittle this guy down. Let's use this throwaway armor. This army. Plus, you can keep retreating, so that's another thing that makes this pretty awful. Just gonna hope this army does some damage. I got one of them down, it looks like. Let's get these guys back on the boat. So they're down to 12. Come on, guys. Do something. Thank you. Is that everybody? So that was actually a pretty damn stout defense. All right. Who wants to get a look in here? So it's a pretty nasty technique. Just keep attacking with those single veterans. It's gonna be 9 on whatever. And then just retreat the instant you see one of your guys drop. We drop down to one guy, and you just retreat. you just continue doing that, and they're just, what are they going to do about it? Heal them up while they're on the boat. Let's see how the tech tree is looking. Damn. Still got units healing up. Gonna want to be healed up real good here because, looks like this capital has, culture working in its favor. Should be. Really? They must have been moving units around. Is there a way to drop this crap off faster? I don't think so. Not at the end of your turn. I think they have an answer for this. All right, see how this goes. Mark set. Got one of them. Come on, guys. Yep, it's looking bad. Getting upgrades and everything. Sick. Obviously, it's kind of a pain in the ass to micromanage all these units, but the dividends are so good, it's worth it. Pretty sweet city they just gave me. So, got three capitals. You can make this even more devastating. Just if you can manage to get a spy on each attack. That is a huge difference. If you can drop it from 15 to 12. And have 9 on 12s over and over. Pretty brutal. So, let's go figure this boat out. Wish I could afford a spy. I'll try to afford it for, the Greek. That can be a little painful. May as well switch to gold. I don't really need all that other stuff. Well, ideally, you could switch to gold way earlier. You could switch to gold as soon as you get 5 techs. I just knew it wasn't going to be that important. I mean, I don't really need literacy, I mean. Nice! They built the Colossus for me. That's very nice of them. Anyone else? These guys all healed up. Anyone else? Nope. Well, they're going fundamentalism. I may as well, head over just in case they decide to go crazy on me. Should be fine though. Thank you. doesn't matter too much right now. All that matters is that boat full of legions. So they're still using archers. That means they're doomed. You just gotta be really, you gotta be on top of that trigger. You gotta be ready to retreat. Don't get too cocky. You see that guy drop, you run. Last thing you wanna do is lose a good legion like that. Thanks for the Colossus. They were definitely going the tech route. So you can see, this is a pretty dominant strategy, even on deity. And it works on human opponents too, so you can definitely have some fun with this one. Let's get a spy out this time. And hopefully the Greek don't have one defending their city. We'll find out soon enough here. Put him here. This guy first. Thank you. You look. These icons get so screwed up. I don't understand how they could not code this ping properly so that it would indicate the correct status of these guys. A lot of bugs in this game. It's a great game, but damn. Patch the game enough, you would think you'd be able to patch these incredibly simple things. Well, there's really no reason. I'll just wait till next turn, there's nothing. It's gonna be pikemen either way. Beefy. Can I do it? We shall see. Well, this is a good sign. That way I get to mess their fortification up a little bit. So let's see what we can do. Start off with the highest damage single unit guys. That was really good. Treated too early there. So it looks like they have two armies. I know I damaged that other one. How many guys do I have here? 1, 2, 3. A lot. Wait. About 10. Favor already. I mean, this is crazy. I haven't even gotten down to single units yet. I mean, I haven't even had to form up armies yet. That's gotta be the sickest strategy, man. It is so crazy. I mean, think about it. You're retreating, which means all you gotta do is form up an army when you're all done, and then just attack again. It's crazy. Then you attack with an army, which is even stronger. Unbelievable. You would need like four or five armies probably to hold up. Fully fortified. I mean, that's just nuts. Well, if you haven't seen that strategy before, that probably blew your mind. It's a really sick strategy. Has a cool, it's just a kind of a tricky thing you wouldn't really think of at first. I didn't find out about that strategy until much later. Years later after it came out, so. But, it's a deadly one, and it just, I mean, as you can see, it just destroys them. Even the Greek, it doesn't even matter. Thankfully, I had the spy, too. I mean, you could just, there's so many ways to just flatten a city using that technique. The crazy part is, I didn't even have a good start. I didn't have a whale. I mean, I had good gold, but Spanish, I always get good gold, pretty much. Unless you get screwed over somehow. So, that's all for this week, guys. I may do one more. I'm going to try to do 2 videos a week. I'm not sure if I can do that, but if I have time, I'm going to try to find time to do it. And this has all been uploaded in one video instead of 5 or 6 parts like I have been previously. I think it's going to be better. I don't know. I'm going to try and see. It's better because then if you share the video, you're just sharing the whole thing. You know, then people don't have to go look around for the other parts and just keeps it all in one place. I think it may be a better thing to do that. So, hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked it, go ahead and like it. And subscribe if you enjoyed what you saw. I'm going to make a lot of Civ Rev games. And then I'm also planning more gaming-related kind of videos. And I also do some web development and web development videos and videos on my own projects, stuff like that. So if you're interested in that kind of content, definitely subscribe, and I think you'll be happy with what you see. Anyhow, that's all for now, and I'll see you next video.